Good evening, Professor. My topic for entrepreneurship assignment for semester 2 is Life Lessons from the Story of Eklavya. As we all know the story about poor boy Eklavya, which grew up to be a potential warrior and a potential competitor for Arjun. Long ago there lived the Pandavas and Kauravas, the princes of Hastinapura city. The Pandav prince Arjun and was Drona's favorite student. On the other hand, Eklavya was a poor commoner boy who wanted to be Drona's pupil. But Drona refused to teach him as he was from a lower class of the society. Eklavya was so determined that he carved a statue of Drona and practiced alongside that. The following weeks later, one day the princess and their teacher Drona came to the same forest, and as Arjuna aimed at a particularly different target, an arrow pierced the target. Shocked, the boys and the teacher looked around and they saw Eklavya, who went up to touch Drona's feet. Drona asked Eklavya, "Who's your teacher?" And Eklavya just quietly led him to his statue. There was a promise that Drona gave to Arjun before mentoring him, that Arjuna would be the greatest warrior the world has ever known, the greatest archer the world has ever known. But as Eklavya was much better than Arjun, he was failing his promise. As a result, Drona asked for the Guru Dakshina from Eklavya. The Guru Dakshina was the sacrifice of his right thumb, which disabled Eklavya permanently, as he could not no longer practice archery with the same precision as he did before. But Eklavya wordlessly cut off his right thumb and laid it at Drona's feet. So the commencement fulfilled. Now, there are particularly three life lessons learned from the whole of this story. The first one is, one must have the utmost faith and belief in their own self, rather than following another person's examples and teachings. You can never be that experienced in the art of living that you can actually find out about other people's true intentions. The second lesson is by far the most important and valuable lesson in the story. Self-learning is the best way to achieve mastery in something. But what plays the great role in actually becoming the best of everyone is competing with yourself, so that you may win every single day. The third and the basic lesson that many stories of the ages have come to express is putting your egos aside. No good has ever come out of it. Mastering your mind. The only place you suffer the most in life is in your own mind. Lesson one, these are the explanations of the lessons. Utmost faith and belief in their own self. If Eklavya had this quality, he'd be knowing that his guru is just asking for his thumb because of his ego and his promise towards Arjun that he'll be the greatest archer of all time. If Eklavya had decrypted the true intentions of his guru, he would not be having such a tragic end. But his unyielding respect and devotion towards Drona clouded his judgment, and he sacrificed his talent and chance without any questions. Who knows, he might have turned the Kurukshetra battle in the Pandavas' favor single-handedly. Second lesson, competing with yourself. What made Eklavya beat the best known archer in the world is not the amount of strength or hours of practice or even the complete devotion towards his guru, but the sheer amount of will and the determination to beat himself every single day. He was competing with himself, not any other archers, not even Arjun. Every time he'd be picking up his bow, he must have been thinking that if I don't shoot better than I'd done yesterday, all of my efforts from day one would get wasted. On the other hand, Arjun was competing with other warriors like Karn. He never wanted to conquer himself. He just wanted to be known as the best among others. Plus, he never had Eklavya as his competitor. He might have defeated Eklavya had he known about him. So Arjun too never had the fair time to practice for such talented warrior battle. Lesson 3. Master your mind. Nobody in the whole of this story has displayed this quality. Drona, as a matter of fact, was the most experienced of all, and he had to be the wisest of all of as well. Therefore, he should have not asked for such a sacrifice that would leave Eklavya unable to continue in archery. Arjun, on the other hand, should have invited Eklavya to a fair battle, but instead, he complained to his guru about fulfilling his promise to him. That way, he never actually defeated Eklavya. He just manipulated his win by forcing Eklavya to forfeit. Eklavya was as naive as a child. He should have judged both Drona and Arjun, and maybe even confronted Arjun for an actual fair battle. That way, he'd be proving himself and in turn also earning respect from some of the greatest warriors ever. Thank you. That's all.